Okey-dokey, gang. Great turnout today. Let's get to it! Now. Now, what's the most important element of any relationship?
Distance.
Good try, Chris, but no, it's communication that we're looking for here. We want to open up a channel of exchange between partners, an active dialogue to express ourselves and reach each other at our cores. How's your core?
Rock hard.
Great. See? Good communication, Chris. Thank you for sharing. Now, what I want from all of you is to follow Chris's example and engage in some active dialogues of your own. Each of you is going to reach out to someone who you might have some personal conflict with and open an active dialogue to put those troubles to rest. And then next Wednesday, you'll all have the chance to share how active dialogue impacted your situation.
Okie dokie, Professor Wiener. Super cool assignment.
Well, you're welcome, Chris.
Hello?
JP, it's not ringing.
Maybe something's wrong with it. Or maybe someone's been trying to reach us for hours, but we can't hear them over the sound of Louis's incessant apple crunching.
And how would you prefer I eat my apples, JP? Shall I unhinge my jaw like a garter snake and swallow them whole?
All right, enough. JP, I know things have been slow right now, but that does not give you the right to start acting like a dick.
Ha, start.
Am I the only one around here who cares about maintaining our numbers?
JP, we've been busting our asses for weeks. Don't you think it might be nice to take a break?
Nobody pays you for taking breaks, Zoey! All right, I'll have to take matters into my own hands.
And what do you plan on doing? Assigning everyone homework yourself?
No. Even better, guerrilla advertising. You'll see. By the end of this, we'll have more work than Joan Rivers' plastic surgeon.
Well, guess that means we get to go home early today.
Zoey and Louis, one Chris Pearson is here to see you.
Okay, you can send her in.
Thank you, Raymond.
Glad it could be of help. Is there anything else you need?
No. Thank you, Raymond.
Do you mind? So what can we help you with, Christina?
I have this bullshit psych assignment due next Wednesday.
Whoa. I understand not liking your homework, but psychology is not bullshit. What's the assignment?
I have to talk to someone I hate, try not to hate them anymore, and then talk to my class about it.
Well, that's valuable. Whenever there's a conflict, it's
Yeah, we get it. Your major's important. So, with whom will we be conversing?
My sister, Stacy. She's a bitch.
Care to elaborate?
Have it to you by Wednesday.
Well, she's charming.
Charming or not, she is a customer. And JP's right, business has been slow.
Yeah, I don't understand that. What could possibly be happening?
I've got 15 new orders for you, sir. All due within the week.
Well done, Raymond. And do our fair Veritas tutors suspect any funny business on your part?
No, sir. I don't think so. They were a little concerned about their plunging client numbers.
Plunging?
But I...
Raymond, how many cases have you been siphoning off of them?
Well, I was under the impression that you'd want all of them.
All of them?!
You're going, dingus.
Louis,
leave your little brother to me. Ray, you were supposed to intercept half of Veritas's clients.
Half!
If they lose all their clientele, Who do you think they'll question first?
Well, I just don't...
Yeah, how about the guy who's handling their schedule, you fucking bonehead?
Well, I let them have one of their clients this week. I just feel absolutely awful stealing from them.
Raymond, we're not stealing from them. Where would Veritas Tutors be if it weren't for my... our expertise. We've boosted their credibility, and thus their business. And what do we get to show for it?
Nothing.
It's a travesty.
Travesty.
All we're doing is taking the business that is rightfully ours.
Well, I was thinking, Hawk, sir, what if, instead of siphoning their customers, we forged a partnership to expand both businesses? They actually are a fantastic team, particularly that Zoey Stone. She's, well, quite special to me, and...
Did she touch your penis?
I beg your pardon?
Did she touch your penis? You obviously like her. I'm just trying to gauge the situation.
Gauge the situation? Zoey is a nice girl!
I'm not saying she's not nice. I'm just... She's such a weenie. Enoch!
It's a wonder your parents allow you two back into their home. Look, Ray. If we share clients with Veritas, we attach our name to theirs. And if we attach our name to theirs, our risk increases. Believe me when I tell you, our current arrangement is the safest option. Now, what I need from you is to stick very close to our friends at Veritas. Blend in with them. Can you do that for me, Raymond? That's a good boy.
What's this girl's address again?
4103 Locust. Do you have some sort of game plan here, Zoey? I have no idea how we're supposed to engage in an active dialogue with a girl we've never met.
It's just talking, Lou. We'll go in, ask her some basic questions, take some notes, and get out. Easy.
Can I be of service?
Ray! How long have you been there?
And why are you wearing that?
Do you like it?
It's very similar.
Thanks.
Ray, we're about to...
mediate a conflict. For a psychological experiment. It's for a new, therapeutic practice I'm researching. A stranger conflict resolution.
Wow. Sounds neat. Let's go.
What if he finds out we're helping Chris cheat?
Ray? I think we're good. Who knows? Maybe he'll even be of help.
You've got questions, we've got answers. Count on Veritas Tutors for all your tutoring needs.
Where is everyone?
Class. Stacy.
Yeah?
I'm Zoey. This is Louis, and that's Ray. We're friends of your sisters. Could we just come in and talk to you for a minute?
Sure, I guess.
Thank you.
Mother, I've been wondering if I could talk to you about something?
Why, of course, Chazzy. What's on your mind?
Well, I've been putting a lot of thought to my plans for the future, and...
Chazzy, you don't need to worry about having future plans. You just leave that all to Mother, dear. Mommy's gonna get you back into acting.
What? But
oh, isn't it exciting, Chazzy? Soon you won't have to deal with all this school nonsense.
But Mother, I like school. I was even thinking about maybe applying for law school.
Law school? Oh, but Chazzy, you're an actor. It's in your blood. You wouldn't want to contradict your blood now, would you?
I guess not.
Of course not, dear. Now don't you trouble your little head with any more thoughts of school. I'll hear no more of it.
I'm working while we do this. I have too much to do today.
Oh, is it homework? Because we could help you.
Like I'd ever need help. No, I'm sifting through job offers from employers all over the country, but I can't seem to find one that doesn't require teamwork. I'm not a people person.
Really? Well, Chris actually wanted us to come by and talk to you about your relationship.
With who?
With Chris, your sister.
What about it?
She mentioned there's been some tension between you two in the past. Any truth to that?
No, I don't talk to her.
Well, why not?
She doesn't bring anything to the table.
Emotionally, or I'm not sure I follow.
She's stupid. Why waste my time talking to that twerp when I could be getting my work done?
Well, sometimes it can be nice to take a break from work and spend some time with family.
One, no it's not. Two, nobody pays you for breaks. And three, nobody's paying me for this little chat, so would you two half-wits like to tell me the point of this?
Yeah, she told us to come by and tell you to stop being such a bitch.
Excuse me?
You heard me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Zoe?
Yeah?
Yeah!
Yes! Who the hell do you think you are?
I'm your therapist, bitch!
Really?
Ow, my hair! Stop!
Oh, I see great success in your future, but only if you use Veritas Tutors for all your tutoring needs. What's up? You need a tutor?
Okay, class. Today's the day. Now, who would like to share their active dialogue experience first, Chaz Winston, how about you kick us off?
Well, after engaging in active dialogue with someone very near and dear to me, I'd have to say, it's important to listen to both sides of argument, unless, of course, your side is silenced, in which case you'll never be free, and you'll be trapped in your mother's blood-curdling death grip forever. Her ever so comforting death grip.
But why? Why must you ignore my wishes, Mother? Why?
Shit.
Well, thanks for sharing, Chaz. Sounds like you've got a doozy of a pickle there. Interesting stuff. How about you, Chris? Would you like to share with us?
Yeah, sure. I talked to my sister, Stacy. And what I learned in talking to Stacy is that I fall fairly low on her list of what's important.
And when you prioritize quantifiable gains over people, you put a price on yourself. And even if you're the highest grossing person on the planet, nothing compares to the feeling of truly caring about someone. To give part of yourself to others, that's invaluable.
Ray got all of that out of our meeting with Stacy? Maybe I'm not as well-versed in psychology as I thought.
Don't beat yourself up. It's hard to see something when you're so close to it.
I guess.
All right, so I've got one more advertising idea, but we're gonna need a scented candles, a massage table, and
some sort of exotic animal.
JP!
No, it doesn't have to be an exotic animal, but we can paint tiger stripes on a house cat or something.
We need to talk.